نستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His forgiveness, we seek Allah's assistance, we seek Allah's help, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this year a happy year for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us success and to give us well-being and taqwa in this year and every year to come. Ask Allah to protect our families, to protect our children, and to make them inshallah righteous, pious, good citizens, good to their parents. Ask Allah to soften their heart and make them generous and kind and caring for their families. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. The surah we started from last time is Surah Tabarak. The first surah of the Juz 29, the surah number 67. Tabarak alladhi biyadihi al-mulk. And it is 30 ayahs. 30 ayah, very short surah. But the Prophet said it's the surah that will help you in the qabr. It will help in the grave, in the barzakh, in the, you know, the time between this life and the hereafter. There's some people in the grave for the last million years. Different life, how they live, Allah, we don't know. But it's a life. It's a form of life. We know how, this life, we eat, we drink, we sleep, we earn money, we build houses. But we were in the womb. We don't know how we survived in there. Every one of us was submerged inside the womb for 9 months. Before that, we were in a life also. But which one? We don't know. It's in the alam al-ruh, in the soul. Our ruh was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then He sent it into the body, in the womb of the mother. Then we came out of this earth. Then we go back again into the earth. In the grave, it's life. It's life. It's called barzakh. The surah Tabarak will keep on trying to ask Allah's forgiveness. The Prophet ﷺ said, it accepted. Allah accept the request of the surah. So Surah Tabarak, inshallah, every one of us need to read it and listen to it. It's a beautiful surah. So we reach the ayah number 12. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. Those who know Allah in private, who know Allah when they are alone. It's good to know Allah in the masjid. Everybody can pretend to be Mr. Mawlana, Mr. Imam, Mr. Sheikh, in the front of the people. But in private, when you're by yourself, when your own bedroom, when your curtain are pulled, lights off, mom and dad asleep, internet is on, the whole world is open. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one that gave you the eyes. He is the one that gave you the brain. He is the one that gives electricity and give the internet and give the money and give the time and give the energy. There's so many million people are sick. Sick in hospital and drips and stuff. They can't do what you do. So if Allah gives you time and energy and health and wealth, you use it to displease Allah in private, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, be careful. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who will really respect Allah and fear Allah and love Allah when they are by themselves, they will have huge reward. لهم unforgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah knows how big the reward the person will be given. Wallahi, I was just listening to a story today on the news from Gaza. People forgot Gaza. It's destroyed. Absolutely destroyed. The school, the mosque, the street, the water, the electricity, everything is destroyed. And one person in Gaza, a cleaner, he cleans public parks in Gaza. You know what? He found a bag with $30,000. A cleaner in Gaza, in a place where a dollar makes a difference. He found the bag with $30,000. But this $30,000 belonged to an accountant, a payroll person. He works in a soft drink company, and he's taken that from that money to go and pay the salaries, and he lost it. A good person, man, beautiful boy, face, big, you know, alam to salah on their face, the, you know, the prayer, the sujood, and he lost the money. He went to the police station. He says to the cop, "I've lost $30,000," and he was crying. The cop didn't believe him. The cop says to him, just look in the car. You're in Gaza, man, $30,000. You can just travel now and leave this horrible prison. It's like open prison." So the cops, they don't believe the honest man, the HR man, the payroll man. They said, no, let's search. And they went and searched his house, searched his car. Search. And the man says, "Subhanallah, I've lost them telling you." So they said, "What do you want us to do?" The police. He says, just here's my phone number. If somebody, honest person, may find it, he will ring me. 2 hours later, the cleaner found the money and gone to the police station and says, "I found this money. Where is the owner?" Wallahi, the friends of the cleaner, those friends, they say he just borrowed 2 shekels from us, less $2 to buy food for his family. And he refused to take the 10% gift. You have 10% of what you find. He refuses. Now they need nothing. It's not my money. This is the ayah. In those who know Allah in private, who know Allah when they are by themselves, they know Allah when there's nobody else looking. These are the people that they will be in the rank of the messengers and the prophets and the martyrs. These are the people that Allah will give them their prize in front of humanity on the Day of Judgment. Allah says, وَأَسِرُّ قَوْلَكُمْ أَوَجْهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. You say it openly, you say it privately, you keep it a secret. Allah knows the emotions inside the chest. Before it became words, before it became secret, before it became idea, Allah knows it. He knows what goes inside more than ourselves. He knows more about us than we know about ourselves. So we need to deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with love. We need to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, you know us more than we know ourselves. You must know the right thing for us. We will obey you because we love you, because we care about your pleasure. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. He knows the smallest thing that goes in our mind. He knows it. And the most terrible thing, that you care about everybody else in the world and not care about Allah. This is terrible. That somebody will be caring about, maybe my father will see me, maybe my community will see me, maybe my mom will see me, maybe, but they don't care that Allah is watching all the time. Allah is watching them all the time. And they say, "Oh, now nobody can see me. Now, no. That is, shaitan is tricking you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. He is with you wherever you may be. Then Allah says, for those people who don't think about Allah, Allah says, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Allah says, He made you. He made you. You know, every one of us have a mobile and we think we know our mobile. You know, we think we know it. I know that I can do that. But give it to the one who invented. Go and sit with the engineer who put the circuits together. He knows it way more than you do. You think you know your house. But talk up to the engineers and architects and the builders and the firm that put together every single nail. They know your own house more than you do. We think we know ourselves. Allah made us and He knows us more than we do. Wallahi, Allah knows us more than we do ourselves. And that's what Allah says, أَلَّا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ. You think He's keeping a secret? You think He's keeping the stuff private? No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows us because He made us. وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. He has full news, full knowledge of everything that we go through. Then Allah says, reflect, because this surah is about reflection. This surah is about knowing who Allah is, about getting closer to Allah. Allah says, هُوَ الَّذِي. He is the one. You want to know who Allah is? Do you really want to know Allah? Here's the description. He is the one who الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا. He made the earth for you. He knows you. He knows your need. He made the earth, the whole planet, designed perfect for human life. And then he says, ذَلُولًا. ذَلُولًا is mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah. When Musa alayhi salatu wasalam asked the Israelite to slaughter a cow. And they said to him, ما هي what is the بقرة and he says بقرة ذلول the same word ذلول لا تسقي الأرض لا تسقي الحرفة ذلول لا شيء ذلول it means humble ذلول it means under control ذلول it means obedient Allah says the earth he made it for you different than any other planet in the billions and billions and billions of galaxies The earth is the only one that has beautiful weather, beautiful temperature, beautiful water to drink, beautiful breathe of air, beautiful flowers and colors, beautiful. Allah says He made the earth like a beautiful domesticated animal. You just take control. You want to build a road? Build a road. You build a school? Build a school. You want to have a farm? Have a farm. You want to plant apple? Plant apple. Grow anything you want as if you are God in control of this planet. Who made it like that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, He is the one. You want to know who Allah is? He is the one that made this earth zalul for you. A place of comfort, a place of enjoyment, a place of happiness. It's the planet Earth. By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هو الذي جعلكم أرضا ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور. Travel from end to end of the planet. You are allowed to go anywhere you like and eat from whatever you find. From Allah's provision, but know full well that this earth is like a ride. If Allah gives the picture, it's like an animal, it's like obedience animal, and you're just traveling from end to end, you don't stay with an animal forever. You know, in the old days, when the surah was revealed, people were riding animals. Now, it's like a train, a plane, a bus, a ship, this whole earth is like that, traveling in the ocean of time. You don't stay on the ride forever. You have to get off. You have to leave. Our soul have to depart. And that's what Allah says. Eat and drink and enjoy yourself. But know full well, you're going to answer for it. Because back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everybody's going. Wa ilayhi nushur. To Allah is the final return. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Allah is the one that gives us earth and commands it to obey our commands, and command the earth to behave. He also can command it to go wild. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, how do you feel safe? أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضِ How do you human being disobey Allah and you feel safe? Displease Allah and feel safe that no earthquake will suddenly wipe out the whole city and everybody in it. It happens. Allah subhanahu gives us example. Earthquake happens, tsunami happens, volcano happens, wild wind happens, wild waves happen. Just small tiny samples, only here and there in the small villages, just as a reminder that you are not in ultimate control, there is someone else who's in control. Because if you're in control, stop it from happening. We can't stop it from happening. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, how can you feel safe disobeying Allah, displeasing Allah, that the earth will suddenly go wild? The earth will just suddenly violently shake and you get buried in it. We see the news all the time now. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our community and protect the ummah. فَسَتَعْلَمُوا أَمْ أَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يُرْسِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ حَاصِبًا Or there is no safety in here. This is just a temporary journey. Allah says a dry wind, hot dry wind can burn everything you own. And subhanAllah, this surah is there. And look, watch the news. There is hundreds of fires now in Australia. Hundreds of wildfire, they call it. Dry wind can cause everything we own to go in the air. May Allah save us. فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ كَيْفَ نَذِيرٌ Don't wait for that day to know that this is a true warning. Don't wait to say, oh, we didn't hear the warning. We didn't know that there was, you know, we're going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So everything we do, everything we act in here, we're going to answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. وَلَقَدْ كَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَكَيْفَ كَانَ نَكِيرٌ So many communities and nations didn't follow the order, didn't follow the warning, didn't follow the advice from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how terrible the life became. How terrible the life became. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us, human beings, to live by moral code. Do this and don't do that. For who? For our own sake, for our own happiness, for our own sanity, for our own decent life. But look now. Now it's just going from bad to worse every single day. Every single day something becomes legal, something becomes allowed. What was 30 years ago, unimaginable, now it's just normal. Now it's actually celebrated. 30 years ago, in this country, women used to wear gloves to go in public. Women used to put gloves on and hats on in here, in this country, not in Saudi, in New Zealand. Women used to cover 30 years ago. Now, it's unimaginable, it's being celebrated, glamorized. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who disobey Allah and reject the warning, reject the message, they're not making their life easy, they're not making their life beautiful, they're making their life more miserable. More miserable. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, again, do you want to know who Allah is? أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا إِلَى الطَّيْرِ فَوْقَهُمْ صَافَّةً. Can't they keep looking up in the creation of Allah? Example, the birds. Allah says, look up in the sky and see the bird flying. Look at the billions of birds that migrate, crossing thousands of miles. Tiny birds. And you know what? They're not flapping the wings. Allah says, Safat. Safat means the wings are straight. Some birds have a lock in their wings. When they travel for a long distance, they open that lock and the wing just stay, the wings spread open straight. They don't flap it. Allah says, who is making them flap like this? Who designed the system? You know, who is in control? Because any of us loses control for 2 seconds driving, disasters happen. And this whole universe, no control. Going for billions of years, beautiful system, beautiful current, beautiful temperature, beautiful level of oxygen, level of nitrogen in the air, and no control, nobody's in control. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, just reflect. Use the intellect you have, use the information you have, use the beautiful guidance, the Quran, and you will know that Allah is the most caring, Allah is the most beautiful, Allah is the most kind. And He says, just look at the bird. Who is keeping them up? You know, some birds cross the oceans flying, tiny birds. Who guided them? Who is helping them? Who is providing for them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, مَا يُمْسِكْهُنَّ إِلَّا الرَّحْمَنَ. The one who is holding them up there is the most kind, is the most caring, is the most beautiful. Allah's name, Ar-Rahman subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ بَصِيرٍ. He is in full view of everything. No matter how tiny, small birds or huge, big nations, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in full view and He's taking full care of them. أَمَّنْ هَذَا الَّذِي هُوَ جُنْدٌ لَكُمْ يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ الرَّحْمَنِ. Or do you have an army that will save you and help you when tsunami arrive, when the volcano arrive, when the earthquake arrive, when the human have an army that will protect them, that they will take care of them as Ar-Rahman, the most merciful and caring, taking care of us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, nobody, no human being can take care of us as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. In الْكَافِرُونَ إِلَّا فِي غُرُورٍ. Those who reject the message, those who disbelieve in the promise of Allah, they are just in a state of delusion. أَمَّنْ هَذَا الَّذِي يَرْزُقُكُمْ إِنْ أَمْسَكَ رِزْقَهُ. Or what happens if Allah stops provision? What happens if Allah stops rain, stops wind, stops the cloud, stops the oxygen? Yeah? What happened to human being? If Allah withhold His provision, what will happen to human being as a race? بَلَّجُّوا فِي عُتُوٍ وَنُفُورٍ. But human being, they just gone far, far, deep and deep into arrogance. Arrogance towards who? Towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنُفُور. Nufur is rejection. They just rejected the Quran. They don't want anybody to tell them that's allowed and that's not allowed. Nobody, no human being likes to be told. But the Muslim, they humble themselves. They believe that Allah is more powerful, Allah is more caring, Allah is more beautiful, and we're going to listen to Allah's command and we'll be happy one. أَفَمَن يَمْشِي مُكِبًّا عَلَى وَجْهِهِ أَهْدَى. أما يمشي سويا على صراط المستقيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you're going on a journey. You're traveling in a journey. And when you travel in a journey, you need to look up. You look ahead. See what's ahead. Plan for the meeting with Allah. Plan for the questioning. Yeah? So there's the picture is being painted in the surah. Allah says, imagine somebody who's not looking ahead. مُكِبًّا عَلَى وَجْهِهِ keeping his face on the ground. Somebody is just not looking up. Is that will be guided? Will that person reach the right destination? Or the one who has a guidance and going on a straight path? Allah says, those who don't obey Allah, those who reject the command of Allah, those who are arrogant towards Allah, they are like those who are looking in the ground. All their life, all their goals, all their dream, all their objective is the dirt, is this planet, this earth. What more can we enjoy? What more can we have pleasure of? What more can we eat? What more can we have fun with? There is no planning ahead of the one who brought us into this planet. What does he want from us? Why did he bring us into existence? Why there is messengers? Why there is universe? Why there is galaxies? Why there is... Who's in control? Yeah? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the example of those who disobey Allah is like somebody just having their face on the ground. They're not looking ahead, they will never reach a destination. Compared to the one who's ala sirat al-mustaqeem, on a straight path, they will reach the right destination. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from them. Qul, tell them. So Allah is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them. Qul, huwa alladhi ansha'akum. Yeah? Tell them, he is the one, ansha'akum. He is the one that created you. Remember the other ayat says, he created you, he knows you more than you know yourself. And here, he's giving us more honor. Ansha'a, it means he raised you high. He built you up. You have the potential to look up, to do way more better things than just being stuck on the ground, stuck on the planet. You need to work for the hereafter as well. قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَكُمْ He is the one that made you to stand up tall and not to stick your face down on the ground, on the dirt. To stand up tall, you need tools. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ And he made hearing for you. You can listen to the message. You can listen and reflect on it. Because this is the means of our education and our knowledge. وَالسَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ And sight. You can see the sky, you can see the galaxy, you can see the information, you can see the birds. وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ The heart and the intellect and the intelligence also to passionately believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ How little you're grateful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, with all this planet, with all this sky that is look up, with all this equipment that they gave to us, very little that human reflect and say, thank you Allah for the hearing. Thank you Allah, I'm able to see. You know that there is more than 300 million deaf people in the world. 300 million people, they can't hear. More than 250 million, they can't see. Humans like me and you, there is more than 65 million humans on a wheelchair. And we complain that we only have a bike, we don't have a car. Or we have a cheap car. There's millions, tens of millions of people who can't walk. They will never walk for the rest of their life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ How little you're grateful. How little you say, thank you Allah for all the blessing that I have. قُلْ هُوَ Again, tell them. You want to know who Allah is? هُوَ He is the one. هُوَ الَّذِي ذَرَأَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ He is the one that created you without help from anybody. He is the one that created you without previous samples, without any example, because the creation of Allah from nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, be and it is. Be and it is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one that created you. He is the one that spread you out on the planet. He is the one that made you many. Billions of human beings ever lived by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ They will still reject. Human will still reject and say, when is that talking about the Day of Judgment, Day of Judgment, Day of Judgment. If you're truthful, when is it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the believer not to engage in such questions. Such debate and such argument is just useless. Say, إِنَّمَا قُلْ إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Allah knows when exactly it is. Tell them the knowledge of when is it, it's with Allah. It's the same story that the Prophet said about the people of the cave. The kuffar said to the Prophet, tell us about the sleepers, tell us about the myth in use. Hundreds of years, the Prophet didn't have Google, didn't have books, didn't have library, didn't have anything. So they're challenging him, they want him to really have difficulty answering the question. So when he answered the question, they come back and say, سَيَقُولُونَ ثَلَاثَ رَبِعُهُمْ كَلْبُونَ. Were they three and the fourth was dog? Were they five? Were they seven? So they come with useless question. Allah says, مَا يَعْلَمُهُمْ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Tell them, only Allah knows this one. Yeah? When a question like that comes, why the Muslim have a beard? Why the Muslim have a hijab? Why the Muslim eat halal? Why the Muslim stand in line? This is question is distracting. We're talking about who Allah is. Allah says, tell them to look in the sky. Tell them to find a fault in it. Tell them who is controlling and created the system of the bird, the system of the wind, the system of the rain. Who created? This is the question we can ask and discuss. All the other thing will follow. When we agree that there is a creator who is beautiful, who is caring, everything else can follow. But we can't start by why is this, why is that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if we ask you, when is the day of judgment? Say, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Only Allah knows it. Only Allah knows it. وَإِنَّمَا عَنَ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. I'm only giving a warning. فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ زُلْفَةً. I'm only warning. Warning from what? Warning that day, when that day that they're joking about, they're laughing about, they're making fun of, when it comes, سِيئَتْ وُجُوهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The faces of those who disbelieve, they'll be terrible. May Allah save us and protect us. So, when they see the Day of Judgment come, when do they see it? When do the people see the Day of Judgment? It's when you see the angel of death. It's not that billions and billions years away. No. Every human being have Al-Qiyamah Al-Sughra. Man mata faqad qamat qiyamatu. The Prophet ﷺ says, whoever died, his qiyamah started. Because Al-Qabru awwal manazil al-akhirah. The grave is the first step, is number one in akhirah. When is that? It's not hundreds of years away. It's not billions of years. It's not, no. It is few years, if you're lucky. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our death the best day for us, inshallah, when meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who reject, فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ زُلْفَةً. When they see that they getting closer and closer, سِيئَتْ وُجُوهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. The faces of those who disbelieve are going to look terrible. وَقِيلَ هَذَا الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ بِهِ تَدَّعُونَ. It will be said, that's what you were asking for. That's what you keep mocking and making fun of. It is here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. قُلْ tell them, أَرَأَيْتُمْ. Let's take it logically, Allah says. Talk to them, tell them. Forget about us. Forget about the billion Muslims, forget. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy us or have mercy on us, it's not your problem. What about you? Think of yourself. Don't worry about what the Muslims do. Don't worry about the messengers. Don't worry about that. Worry about yourself. إِنَّ أَهْلَكَنِي اللَّهُ وَمَنْ مَعِيَ. The Prophet ﷺ, the best human being, was told, tell them, if Allah will destroy me and those who followed me, فَمَنْ يُجِيرَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Who will protect the disbelievers? Forget about us. Think of yourself. Save yourself. Think and save yourself. Just take the guidance and save yourself. فَمِنْ يُجِرَ الْكَفْرِينَ مِنْ عَذَابٍ عَلِيمٍ. Because that day will have a painful punishment. قُلْ tell them, هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ. Our belief is, هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ. He is the most beautiful. Our Creator is the most caring. Our Creator is the most loving. الرَّحْمَنُ. آمَنَّا بِهِ. We believe in Him. آمَنَّا بِهِ. وَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا. And on Him alone we put our trust.
Alone.
In nothing else. Nothing else in this universe we put our trust in. We put our trust in Ar-Rahman. فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ هُوَ فِي ضَلَالِ الْمُبِينَ. Then, that's what we believe in. We will come to know who is in guidance and who is in absolutely clear misguidance. قُلْ, tell them, do you want to know who Allah is? Again, أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَصْبَحَ مَاءُكُمْ غَوْرًا. Tell them, if the water disappeared inside earth. It's very easy to do. If the water that we have, all these rivers, all these lakes, all this bone, disappear and dry, and it's happening now in so many countries. They go to the lake and it's dry. And they claim on bad farming and this way and that way. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if the water disappears, who will bring water for you to drink? Who will bring good water? فَمَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِمَاءٍ مَعِينٍ. This beautiful, crystal clear water. You know, even in so many villages they have rain, you know, collecting red waters. In so many places in New Zealand even. And they drink it straight from the rain. Allah says, who will bring drink water from you? Who will bring this crystal clear, beautiful water that gives life? The one who brings this water is the one we believe in. Is the one we put our trust in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us thankful and grateful for what He gives us. Ask Allah to strengthen our iman and to protect our families and our community. This is the end of Surah Tabarak. Inshallah, next week we start Surah Al-Qalam. Jazakum Allah khair. Subhanahu wa ta'ala.